All right, folks. Now, in this next clip, I want to show you what Charles Darwin himself wrote in his book on the origin of species, what he predicted paleontologists should find in the fossil record if his theory of evolution was correct. I want you to watch.
In 1859, this country estate, 30 miles south of London, was ground zero for a scientific revolution. Here in the solitude of his study, Charles Darwin completed his landmark book on the origin of species. In it, Darwin attempted to explain how every organism that had ever lived evolved from a single common ancestor as a result of natural selection acting on random variations.
The idea of evolution itself, change over time, was not novel with Darwin. What Darwin did that was, I think, really revolutionary was to advance a hypothesis of common ancestry, that all living things were related.
He would have a branching tree pattern, and for a long time, you would only have that one species, and then it would eventually branch into two species, and then more species, and different families, and orders, and classes. And Darwin's thinking, given enough time, those differences accumulate, especially under natural selection, if the environment changes. Those differences accumulate to the point where a thousand or a million generations from now, your great-great-great-great-great-grandchildren will be a different species.
So it is both logically and almost aesthetically a unifying picture, a unifying image that pulls together the whole of life on Earth. And for many biologists, that kind of unification is very important.
Common descent and natural selection became the twin pillars of modern biology, and Darwin's branching tree of life its foremost icon. Yet despite the clarity and detail of his argument, Darwin acknowledged a problem that defied explanation: the Cambrian fossil record.
The distinctness of specific forms and their not being blended together by innumerable transitional links is a very obvious difficulty. I allude to the manner in which species belonging to several of the main divisions of the animal kingdom suddenly appear in the lowest known fossiliferous rocks.
When Darwin was writing The Origin of Species, it was well known at the time that the first fossils of animals appeared suddenly without precursors in the geological record. So there was a deep conflict between what his theory told him to expect to find, namely an abundance of transitional forms going back to that common ancestor for the animals, versus what was there in the fossil record.
Darwin knew that if his theory was true, the older rock strata directly beneath the Cambrian layer should reveal a progression of fossils connecting simple earlier forms to complex animals like trilobites through a trail of incremental steps and failed biological experiments. Such evidence would document the trial and error process of natural selection.
But Darwin says in The Origin, where are these transitional forms? They're not there in the fossil record. What we see instead are fully formed, discrete groups. Now that's a world-class puzzle for someone like Darwin.
And so it's very, very striking, and one can see why Charles Darwin was so puzzled by the Cambrian explosion, because he had enough knowledge even at that time to realize that deep in the Earth history, you just didn't find the animals.
If my theory be true, it is indisputable that before the lowest Cambrian stratum was deposited, long periods elapsed, and during these periods of time, the world swarmed with living creatures. To the question of why we do not find rich fossiliferous deposits belonging to these assumed earlier periods prior to the Cambrian, I can give no satisfactory answer.
All right, Dr. Meyer, Charles Darwin was a brilliant man. When he was faced with this evidence, how did he try and solve this problem?
Well, he had a charming analogy that he developed that in which he likened the history of life, in particular the fossil record, to a book with many chapters in it. And he said, if we can think of the fossil record as a series of layers where the layers represent just different chapters in the history of life, we may have a situation where we have some chapters that have been lost and where we maybe only have a page in one chapter or where there's a complete chapter missing. And so he essentially tried to explain the absence of the ancestral fossils of these Cambrian animals, which he expected on his theory to be there. He explained away the absence of these fossils as a result of the imperfection in the fossil record, that either we hadn't found these fossils yet because we hadn't looked hard enough, or perhaps some layers, for whatever reason, were not preserved. They were eroded away. And so he tried to explain it away that way and analogized it to a book where some of the chapters of the book had been torn out.